Ooh, welcome back to the 100K Pod, Season 3, Episode 19. It's the Super Bowl Spectacular! It's a goal. It's actually the final episode of Season 3, boys. Season 3. This is it.
Unbelievable. We've made it back to Super Bowl. We're up and about. We're excited. We're all a little dusty. We've had a big weekend. We're hurting.
How are you, Jeb?
I'm good. I can't remember my joke right now, so go to you, Lou. Come back to me.
Yeah, well, we should say congratulations to the 100K's very own Brownlow Shark, who was married on the weekend. So congratulations to him and Bonnie. We had a great day.
But, weekend.
We're absolutely shagged. Back on the bottle tomorrow.
Oh, back on the bot, you reckon? What? Jeff, you remember your joke?
What did the tampon pad say to the fart?
What?
You are the wind beneath my wings. Oh, you can't.
Oh, God, I'm surprised you forgot that.
Fuck. That's lifted us. All right, boys, let's get into it now. So, our last pod was...
I should just say, how are you feeling... Since Maccas, we should quickly... Hence, oh, beg your pardon.
I'm just coming under
that. I didn't get that in the script.
On the run sheet.
Thank you, Chief.
Yeah, so our last show was at McDonald's when I had the 24-hour punishment. I was out of there in 10 hours, boys. So 14 Big Macs, 48 nuggets. Was much harder than what I thought. Went out hard early and my guts just did not settle. So.
And about, like, after 7 Big Macs, you were in a bad, bad way, weren't you? Like, you thought you were done at 7.
Yeah, the thought that I would have had to eat another 7, I didn't think I could. And I just found second wind and just... muscled up a little bit and just got it done.
Watching the roller coaster was something special. Something special. Did you have a look? It was under time.
Under time.
Over Big Macs eaten.
Yep.
You did spew or didn't you spew? You did spew and you didn't shit.
Didn't shit.
Not too bad.
Didn't shit for 2 days. I was bound up.
Not too bad.
And then the winners that actually hit the same game multi on that are at Farnlord, Nick Farnback, at Dat Mickey, Matt Dickey, the Shark who just got married, and at Luke Hull. If you guys DM us, we will send you your hat.
But if
you won't be watching, so.
So if you don't DM us. Now, boys, now, even though it was 2 weeks ago, NFC Championship and AFC Championship games, good legs, bad legs.
Bad legs. I had 4 bad legs. I had San Fran plus 10.5. Thought it was an absolute lock. It was probably a bit stiff, isn't it? It's not necessarily bad.
Injuries.
Right. Like quarterbacks, that was a disappointing game. And then I had Pacheco to score, McKinnon receiving yards, Pacheco rushing yards, and none of them hit. So, Lewis.
Yeah, I'm going at 92% the last 2 weeks, so I really could have used that late in the season. My only bad leg was George Kittle anytime. And again, how was I supposed to know that fight for your idol Brock Purdy was going to be out? Das?
Oh, I had Brandon Ayuk. I thought he was going to go over, but no quarterback. It's hard to get the ball to your receivers. And then I did end up taking fucking Joe Mixon last game of the year. I'm like, fuck him. He had 100. The week before, he had 100 plus and a tud, and he didn't get fucking near it. So Joe Mixon
might be out of the league.
For everyone's benefit, let's hope he gets cut so he does never bet on him again.
I never will. Next year, I'll never bet on him once. So, Jeff, some good legs, though?
Yeah, Christian McCaffrey, anytime touchdown. For a team that got pumped, for him still to score. And it was one of the best touchdowns we've ever seen. Oh, so nice. He's started. And then Joe Burrow, over 17.5 rushing yards. That was piece of piss, if you ask me. That was a win.
That Christian McCaffrey touchdown, I watched in slow motion. He's a fucking bull.
Unbelievable.
He's
unbelievable. Under 53.5, that hit. Jalen Hurts under 247. I said he wouldn't need a throw 247 and he didn't.
Nah.
Kashkarius Boyd had his 25. Trav Kelce anytime.
Kashkarius Boyd.
I had Jalen Hurts to rush one in, which I did love. He's done it a lot this year. And Patty Mahomes over. He was at 285. It's close to that for this week. And he airs it out. It's what he does.
He'll be throwing it. He'll air that skin.
So, boys, now, Jeff, I believe this is a bit of a tip that you were going to put into your exotic, so I won't go over that just yet.
Okay.
Yeah, but good. Let's get into a bit of the game script, Jeff. So let's start off. So first touchdown, who's someone that you really like?
As you know, we'll go be last in the first touchdown. You know I am the Melbourne magician, the Southeast Phoenix, the wizard of the West. You know I always hit the first touchdown. I hit it last year with OBJ in the Super Bowl. It is my thing. So, Lewis, who is your first touchdown scorer?
I'm going Jalen Hurts. I like him just to start off, rush one in. I love that. But I think you get about $9 for it, Das.
I'm going Jerick McKinnon. I had him for...
Jerick McKinnon?
Yeah. I had him for a Tudley the other week. Didn't, so he'll punch one in this week. And I think he'll be the first on the first drive.
Hit us, Jeff.
My first, and I think it's the biggest lock of my life, is AJ Brown from the Philadelphia Eagles.
Mm-hmm.
He's only had about 50 yards in his 2 playoff games combined. He's not happy. He's been cracking the shits.
Mm-hmm.
The way I think the game's going to go, I reckon they're going to have it drawn up for him early to get him involved early. I think he's an absolute lock to score the first touchdown. AJ Brown, $10.50. And then, Dallas, I got one more quick one. If the Chiefs were to score the first touchdown,
mm-hmm.
I think Noah Gray at 46-1. The backup tight end will score the first touchdown for the Chiefs.
Well, you reckon they'll put two tight ends out there?
I reckon they'll put two tight ends. Run a blocking. Block, and he'll spread out. All the eyes will be on Kelsey, and I think he's second fiddle will score the first touchdown for the Chiefs if they're to score the first touchdown. Noah Gray, 46-1. I've got a dollar on it there. I'm probably going to have $5 on it, try and win $200 if it wins. That'll be unbelievable.
Love that,
that'd be good. Now, boys, just an anytime touchdown score. Is there someone that you like, Jevy?
Yeah, I'm absolutely loving the odds for Kadarius Toney at $4.40. He basically scored against the Bengals, I think it was, or the Jags, and they bought it back. And he always gets a bit injured, but they always draw up a play for him in the red zone for him to score. He's definitely an inside red zone receiver. He's really crafty. He's a good sort of runner as well. So, yeah, I like Kadarius Toney at $4.40 anytime. I reckon Pat might throw to four different receivers. So he might be one of them. Lou?
I'm not breaking any ground here, but I just can't say no to the $1.90 from Trav Kelce. He's 100% scoring. If the Chiefs are winning, he's 100% scoring.
Four
what?
You'll probably score four touchdowns.
Wow. I like him for two. I definitely like him for two, but you can't say no. We love a multi. We probably shouldn't bet that way, but $1.90 to fill your Santa sack with is just unbelievable.
If you knew a horse was about to run around at $1.90 and it was going to win, you'd bet on it. Exactly. So you might as well just have 10 on Kelsey, $1.90, turn into 90.
Don't have to be fair. He just has to punch one
100%.
In.
Yeah, I'm not breaking any
he's
ground.
He's too fucking good. Now, boys, I'll be taking Juju free time. You can just see, he'll have someone probably in the back of the end zone with a fucking phone ready for him to make a TikTok, and he's just going to blow it up. You probably grab the phone. You can just see it's. I think Juju for $4.90.
$4.90 is nice. Definitely.
Yeah, they feed everyone, so I really like Juju
five,
for any time.
5-1 for basically his number one receiver outside of Kelce is ridiculous odds. Like that's a good bet. $5 anytime touchdown.
We think that they're going to probably put up what 25. Look, we'd say probably 25 plus points easy. So they've got to score a couple.
Theme of the show, I reckon, it's a bit of a spread your chips game. There's so much value out there. Just have 10 on everyone.
Five on everything.
Yeah, five.
Yeah, speaking of spreading it out, boys, best exotic bets.
Here we go.
Jeff, do you have something for us?
Like a dead set lock. It is, we've all agreed on it, it's the bet of the day.
It is the bet of the day.
Heads in the coin toss.
Oh, absolutely.
100%. It is 100% going to be heads. Even on the odds, it's $1.80 heads, $1.90 tails. They know it's going to be heads because it's a lock.
Do we have got some footage, do we not?
We do have some footage. You're probably not going to put it here, but I'll put it up later.
Oh, I could crowbar it in.
All right, done.
Yeah, so we've got some footage. We've done the work in the last fortnight. We sort of did some testing, so we'll throw to that.
We'll
then throw. It's good stuff, that.
It's good stuff. Oh, that's good. Ooh, yes.
Luke.
My best exotic. I like Tom Brady to be shown on the kiss cam to kiss his son. What are your thoughts? No, I love Das, the no touchback. If you're on Instagram today, you would have seen it. It's
hit
28 of the last 31 Super Bowls, Jeb. There hasn't been a touchback. Reason being, the ball is so fucking hard, it has to go straight to Canton to go to the Football Hall of Fame, Das. You told everyone. So you can get $2.10 for no touchback.
I don't know why.
So I think I know why. One, Arizona's an indoor stadium, so it's not going to be as cold, and obviously Phoenix being a warmer weather
it's
state.
Ping off
so,
the boot.
So they're thinking it is, but the balls are that hard that I just can't see it being a touchback. And for $2.10, who cares if it is anyway?
So that means they run it out of the end zone.
Yeah, so a touchback.
Catch and run.
Because the ball is just too hard to kick hard enough.
Right, you know? Right. Like so they catch and go.
Fev used to talk about the Sherrins, the brand new ones you couldn't kick in the first quarter.
At quarter time, yeah, sweet.
So $2.10, use it.
Love that. Now, my exotic, Jeff, if you ever put a bet on or something, you say, I have faith in it, or like you have faith in what you're trying to put your money on.
And when you have a winner sometimes, who do you thank first?
Our man, Jesus. So, boys, what I'll be backing for whoever wins the Super Bowl MVP. Their first person to thank is Jesus. So you can get $2. He needs to be mentioned.
Is that favourite?
The first thing to be mentioned. I'd like to thank.
It says God. No, on the bed it says God, Jesus, or faith. The first person to be thanked.
Are they three markets?
$2.
All religions. Like the first person. That can be owners, teammates. No, we're backing the big man upstairs. Because if you have faith in something, have faith in this bet. This is $2, boys.
And if you've done the form last 2 weeks ago, Pat, first man to thank was God.
Correct.
You always got to thank the big man
if
upstairs.
You like Mahomes to win MVP.
You should.
Sorry, that's my exotic. Now, boys, just what way are you leaning in the actual game?
I'm leaning.
Who's winning?
I've been going up, back in my head. Like, the Eagles are a better team, but I'm going to go the Chiefs. I'm leaning Chiefs. I'm leaning Mahomes. I think the best quarterback in the world is going to get it done. I absolutely love the Chiefs to win. Can't believe they're an underdog when they've got the best player in the game. I understand the next 13 or 15 players are Eagles, but He is the best player. So I'm going to go to the Chiefs. Lewis, who are you going?
Yeah, I'm the same. You have to go with your gut with this one. And I think as well, he's already had the game where you have that one in the box game that you get stopped. And that was Tampa Bay. Correct, that was the one in the box. I don't think you have two of those in your career in the Super Bowl.
Even in that game though, he was fucking insane.
He did
like,
almost
he was hitting guys in the helmet and they were dropping him.
On the helmet, on the numbers, they were dropping him. He's a bit stiff after that game. He was actually pretty good.
Not much analysis there, just purely gut. You can't see him losing.
No, I'm the same. I think I just more want them to win.
Oh, so really we've all gone Chiefs.
Yeah,
I'm always gone Chiefs. Let's go.
Leaning.
What?
We're leaning.
We're leaning in. Now, Jeff, do you have a little multi for us?
I do.
You got a little script.
I do. This is how I think the game's going to play. I think the Chiefs on defense are going to absolutely stack the box and go, Jalen Hurts, if you're good enough to beat us with your arm, beat us. So I absolutely love AJ Brown anytime. Yep. I love him for yards. I love Devontae Smith for yards. I like Jalen Hurts is over 238 because if they run it all day and Pat Mahomes only gets 7 possessions, they want to kill themselves. But if they throw, who's calling you? If they throw and they score touchdowns, at least Pat Mahomes gets back on the field. He gets to reply. He's not just sitting there watching them run. So I'm all in on Hurts is over, AJ Brown yards, Devontae Smith yards, AJ Brown anytime, but still the Chiefs to win. Then we've got it in some of our multis. Basically, every Chiefs receiver for 25 yards is like $1.50. Like, I like them all.
Which is ridiculous.
Pat Mahomes over. Total match points over, 50.5. And like then Kansas, +4.5 for $1.50. Like, I like them outright at 2-1, but +4.5 gives you that field goal, that touchdown, like little edge. Yeah, so that is mine. Kansas +4.5. AJ anytime. Hurts over 238.5. Pat Mahomes over 292.5, over 50.5. I got 50 on that at $11.50 to win $575.
Really nice bet.
My bet of the day. If you want that, DM, I'll send you the bet slip.
My game script, I like the tight ends. So I'm going Kelsey, I'm going Dallas Goedert, going over. So it's 79.5 for Kels, 49.5 for Goedert. Tony, you said Tony for any time. I like him for 25. The reason being, they had their wide receivers that were a little bit injured. I think Juju was injured. I think MVS was injured. And they weren't sure how they're going to go. They're going to be drawing up some stuff for old Tone. And then my man Kenneth Gainwell does. 9.5 receiving yards is his line and 1.5 receptions. So I've got some stats here. In the NFC Championship game, Gainwell played a season high of 31 snaps. That's a lot of snaps for a backup running back.
31 snaps.
In 19 games, the Chiefs allowed 23 backs to catch at least 3 balls. So his line's 1.5 receptions at $1.90. It's good juice. Chiefs are ranked bottom 5 in defending backs in the passing game. And Gainwell has seen a snap share significantly increase in the second half of the season. So take full advantage, I wrote.
That's a great bet. That is great. There's advantage. There's your in the weed sort of stuff. Kenneth Gainwell over 9.5 receiving yards. It'll happen in one catch. Happen by quarter time. You'll be like, why didn't I put that in my multi at $1.80?
You're going to have to do these bets though. The 1.5 receptions, you can't bet it with anything else. So have that into like a quarter on Saturday or something like that.
The Celtics or something.
At Randwick.
Yeah.
The third.
No, you're welcome.
Now, boys, I've just got a little $7.50 thing that I'm playing around with. So I like the over 50.5. Patty Mahomes, I'm always going to take his over, which is only 292. Could throw for 300. Devontae Smith, 40 yards. He'll get the ball. Miles Sanders, I really like how Philly have been running the ball. I don't think they're going to run it a lot, but I think he'll still get his fair share, so he'll still get his 40 yards. Travis Kelce, got him for 50, and then the two other receivers, so MVS for 25 and Juju for 25. So that pays $7.50, boys, and that's where I'll be lock and loading all my money in towards that.
Well done.
Now, we still had to put on 100K because that is the premise of this show.
I've got it if you don't have it.
Yeah, no, that'd be great. So
you've
got it. So we've constructed, we've gone through, we've put a lot of time and effort into this. We've been scratching our head for 2 weeks, and Morgs, if you want to read out what we've come up with.
Travis Kelce anytime touchdown. AJ Brown anytime. Jalen Hurts over 238.5. Patty Mahomes 292.5. Yep. Hurts 40 rushing. Gainwell over 9.5 receiving yards. Pacheco over 15.5 receiving. Dallas Goedert 40 yards. Travis Kelce for 100. So we're predicting a day for him. MVS for 40. Tony for 25 yards. Juju for 40. Miles Sanders for 50 on the ground. AJ Brown for 60 in the air. Devonta Smith for 50 receiving. In the morning. The Raptors at $1.19 and the Celtics for $1.58. Because we're going to have...
On the same game, you can only have it paying $2,500. So,
and the followers, we don't want you to spend your whole Nana's pay packet. So you just got to have 20 on that, pays $5,078 and you get back $101,000.
Get with a couple of mates, $7 each or something.
We weren't going to say this. The best thing about it is if we do have an upset in the morning, we'll reuse the legs.
Yeah, and we'll just fucking put it back on. Hey! Fantastic, boys. I reckon we hit the nail on the head.
Back on the bottle, you reckon?
Oh, so tomorrow, back on the bot, what?
Oh, one quick shout out, Das. Like, shout out, Jaws Bet, new horse racing.
Jaws.
New horse racing tips that we're going to work with in the 100K.
He's a fucking
gun. We started a bet with mates with him. We put some money in. He put some money in. And we just said, you go for work. The best way you can get some of our followers is just back winners. And he went nuts yesterday. He had an absolute day. So follow at Jaws Bet. He was unbelievable. I was really... It was great to watch, really.
It was emotional. Slip.
And yeah, we started with, on the day with 600. And then he put all 27 bets on. We had 50 in the can, and at the end of the day, we're at 1,050. So $450 that's profit.
Good, better than bank interest.
That is a great day.
No, so he did fucking well.
He's going to be running like all things 100K. You see, horses going to be from Jaws Bet. So we're going to keep sharing him, but you got to follow him and you got to subscribe to his service to get all his tips.
Yeah, well, we'll drop it. We'll tag him in the bio.
Yeah,
no one will see this. That's all.
Link in the bio.
It's late in the show,
boys.
They've stopped watching.
Hey, it's been a cracking season.
Hey, thank you, guys.
We're still yet to hit, but
yes,
tomorrow we do.
We'll be at what 65 attempts ish. This is the end of third season.
Yeah,
episode 20, two season to 20 at 65 attempts.
Oh, that's probably what $800 spent. Could have just saved our cash.
Not done this. Just going to work on Sunday, you reckon?
With $800 to be on a show, no one watches.
Ah, it's funny. Well, you have some fun. Oh, exact score, Das. What do you think the exact score is going to be?
It's 37-34, isn't it?
The script score. Funny you say that. You can get that. I got a dollar on that. 81-1. Wow. Super Bowl finish to final score. Eagles 37, Chiefs 34 at 81-1.
Well,
that's Eagles winning. No, but I'm going to go Chiefs 31. Eagles
28.
Yeah, I'm thinking like 27.
28.
31-27. You?
31-28.
Damn, Alex, what do you got?
37-28.
So Chiefs just blow me out.
Chili.
Chili. Baby McRibs. Nobody's watching. Mahomes Super Bowl MVP. Easy work. Hey, thanks God
thanks
first.
Thanks Jesus first.
Heads is a lock.
Hey Zeus, no touchback. Your mum's got a hairy back.
Mahomes' line is 9.5 rushing yards. That'll hit.
No touchback. Your mum's got a hairy backport.
Your dad did his meniscus.
Unwatchable. Yeah, right, let's go. Mum has a hairy backport.